How should you use a margin of error calculator? Margin of error, also called confidence interval, tells you how much you can expect your survey results to actually reflect the views from the overall population. Remember that surveying is a balancing act where you use a smaller group, that is your survey respondents, to represent a much larger one. You can think of margin of error as a way of measuring how effective your survey is. The smaller the margin of error, the more confidence you may have in your results. The bigger the margin of error, well, the farther they can stray from the views of the total population. So here are the four steps that you must follow to use a margin of error calculator to draw out its maximum efficiency. First, define your total population. This is the entire set of people you want to study with your survey. Two, level of accuracy. You need to decide how much of a risk you're willing to take your results will differ from the attitudes of the whole target market. Three, define the sample size. Balancing the confidence level you want to have and the margin of error you find acceptable, your next decision should be defining your sample population. And don't forget that not everyone who receives the survey will respond. Four, calculate your response rate. This is the percentage of actual respondents among those who received your survey. Make an educated guess. If you're sampling a random population, a conservative guess is about 10 to 15% will complete the survey. And that's it. I hope that the video has helped you to understand how to use a margin of error calculator the right way. Please give a thumbs up if you liked the video and don't forget to press that subscribe button. We'll be back soon with another exciting video. Until then, bye-bye.